So how we can add a comment in HTML? It's very simple. In any language, there is a comment that isn't translated by the browser or by the interpreter. So we are here in this line, and you have make these brackets or this opening bracket, this closing bracket, and you have all these markers. And inside this, this is a comment. So when we use this comment, if you can see that this is starting our header, and we can now closing the header. And here is the header tag. This is a comment. If you want a multi-line comment, is very simple. This is first line, and this is the second line. And that's it for commenting in HTML. It's very simple using these lines or these markers, and add a comment as you want. And make sure if you have some div to be organized, you can in the final tag or this tag, which is here, you can add your personal comment, like, and you can make it all caps, end of testimonials or something like this. And this is for the comment. Let's move to the next lesson. How we can add an images. It's very simple using the image tag, and because we are using HTML5, it's now in lowercase, and this is the image tag like this. And we will define the source, we will define the alternative, we will define maybe a class, and let's close the our image. Basically, I have an images inside this folder, which is here. I have some images here, as you can see. I have this image also, and let's rename this one to be maybe background.jpg, and I will move here and make the source to be images and background.jpg. After that, the alternative will be maybe the header or background, and the class will be, if you are using some framework of CSS, this class will be defined according to the framework which you are using. And because we are not using any framework yet, I will save it to be image round maybe. And you can define the width and the height, as I will say. And let's refresh our page here. And because the image is very, very big, it's showing like this. How we can make the image smaller? So inside atom, we will say that the width will be around 600 pixels, and the height will be around 400 pixel. And let's save, and we will refresh now. We will refresh now to see that this is our image, and this is the image which we have made in here. You can change the width and height, and if you make here the round to be 4, it will be fine to refresh here, and it should not the round, but we can use the border, I think. So if we type border and save our file and refresh, you will see that this border has some border, black border, which is here. So let's move to the next lesson or the next item in our HTML. We have now a table, so we'll define an table like this. And closing the table tag. And inside the table, we have table row, which is tr. And we have table data like this, table cell. And let's say, and inside this row, we will say that this is the name, and you have three table data. We have the name and the age, and we have maybe another table data, which is degree. And I will copy this table row three times. And this is name. I will put different names and age maybe 20. And degree ranging from these values and save. Before we save, I will come to the main table and make the border to be black on border. And as you can see, this is our table in HTML. As you can see, because we have a border of 1 pixel, it's like this. Every cell has some border. Let's move to the next step and the next item, which we'll explain, which is the ordered list and unordered list. So we have an ordered list like this. And inside this unordered list, we have the list item. And let's say we have name 01. And I will copy this maybe 4 times. And this will be 2 and 3 and 4 and 5. And what if we make this to be an ordered list? So we have ordered list and we have an ordered list. What if we make this ordered list like this? The same thing, maybe making any a different item, so we can. And I will save, come to the browser and refresh. So this is an unordered list. Which with these disks, and the order list will be starting from 1 to 5. If you want a different type of order list, you will see here the type will be this, and I will make horizontal line, which is here, and another horizontal line here. And let's move to copy and paste a few times. This will be capital A, this will be like this, and horizontal line like this. Let's save, and I will go to the browser and refresh. So we have here this from capital A to E, and from this, according to we have explained, and we have typed that the type will be ranging from this here, ranging from this. So we have explained that the type will be different from any of these lists. What is the next to explain? So assume that you have 2 pages, and I will come here and make a new file, which is page2 or home.html. home.html. Home will be the same. Let's select all and copy and move to the home and paste. And we can delete all these to be just an header one, home page like this. And the paragraph will be this as an text file. And this will be the second page. Alright, and how we can move from this? I will put the link in the top here. And we will see that we have a link to be home.html. And let's go to the next beige. And inside our home, we will say that we have here an index.html. After that, we will say back to index, and let's refresh our page. Go to the next page, back to index, and this is the power of hypertext links, that you can go from one page to another, and this is the basics and the basic foundation of the internet. So that's concluded for this video, and in the next video, we're going to explain how we can add an form to a document or HTML file.